everyone. I'm Jenai2306, but most people just call me Jen. Welcome to my Let's Play of Rimworld. My playthrough is my own take on the Naked Brutality scenario, but instead of just having one person to try and make a go of it, you start with two. Now I am going to be playing with some mods, and if I remember, I will put them in the description or I will pin it as a top comment. So let's get started. So, here's my one. As you can see, I've not disabled anything, so if we dig too far into a mountain, we're going to get the bugs. There's going to be meteorites, raids, everything like that. So, I am going to play on Cassandra Classic, because Randy Random is a git. I tried playing this on him, and I think I had 5 raids simultaneously at the start when I only had 2 people and no clothes, so it didn't go well. Phoebe Chillax was too chillax for this playthrough, even like putting it on rough or on savage, which I don't really like savage. I like sort of going for medium or rough. So I'm going to play on Cassandra, I'm going to play on medium, I am going to put it on commitment mode, so if someone dies, they're dead, we can't bring them back, we can't jump back in the save, anything like that. Now I do have it to auto-save for me every half game day, just so if we do crash, we're not going to lose too much of the game. So, I have got a seed that I want to use, which is the word naked, because we are doing naked and afraid. Generate, thank you. And I have played this seed before, and there is an area that I want to try and find again, which was one that you like and then you can't find it again. Too far. Where is it? Find it again, hopefully. Is it over here? Is it that one? There it is, I found it. It was me being dumb. So yeah, the one I was looking for is, I don't know if you can just about see it past my logo. It is 40.86 degrees north by 17.94 degrees west. So that's the one we want. So let's look at these guys. I'm not going to use prepare carefully, even though I have got it in the mod list. I'm going to be using the random plus. It just makes it a bit fairer. I do always keep this loaded into any Rimworld game I play though, because sometimes you've got certain characters that you've saved and you just want to play with them again. But I'm not going to do that this time. So we are going to pick from the, we're not using you. I want to try and get someone who is not incapable of anything. They may have like some super skills. I'm going to take Haze. I would take you, but you've got a heart problem. Someone super old, no health conditions, and that's about it. So randomize. No, you can't do violence, you can't do dumb labor. Go on, so you're gonna get really hungry really quick, which is not good. I'm willed is brilliant, lazy not good. So no. No. You wouldn't be able to self-tend. You don't do social and you don't do artistic. What's Hayes' plants like? No, we need someone who can grow, really. Night Owl and Sanguine is really good. I think we're gonna go with Chaffinch and Hayes. Okay. So we'll go with these two. Doop doop doop. Load. Doop doop doop. Okay. So get them landed. We will pause. We do not need that helper on. We do want them to rebuild when they need to, so let's have a look. So yeah, I like this one because I can get him to claim this bit and we can build here. And there's a nice bit of fertile ground there. There's not too many hills, so we're not going to just make a mountain fort. We have got running water for the new power generation, the water wheel, which is amazing. It means you don't always have to research batteries straight away because it's like a constant power and it's quite a high power as well. So, first order of business is claim that. Unforbid anything? No, nothing to unforbid because we did start naked. So, we want you to drop them. We want you to harvest them and that and anything that there is. Because she has nothing. Let us set you to both plant cut. Both construct for now, and there we go. So, I'm just while I'm here, I'm just going to turn them off while I remember, because we don't need them yet. So yeah. I might speed them up a little bit just so they get this like plant cutting started for like the food and the trees, because I can't tell them to go and construct anything until we actually get some materials, as you can see. Actually going about it the right way. Get some food together first. Might actually say do a stockpile there. Made it critical for food. And then just select all your food and tell you to get that hold in. Door there. Make two beds. Probably a light. Passive cooler. Campfire. Build a porch roof basically. Spot, craft spot, and the craft spot. Make some traveler as soon as you can. Make two clubs. Make two bows. Oh, Chaffinch, that's mean. Okay, while they are asleep, let me set up work. And just copy that down. So I am going to set them to both craft as and when. Luckily it's not too cold, as you can see, instead of having to always look down here and you do that and you're like, no, stop moving. I can just look up here and I can also toggle that, so it'll tell me, right, this room, it's getting to above the outside temperature. And it's at a good temperature at the minute. And it's getting hot. That's fine. I'll leave it on speed 3 for a bit. Let me speed through this, get set up. Well, hey, we've got one bed. So, the way I got them to just instantly deconstruct and rebuild, until they got a okay quality, is it's called the quality builder mod. And basically, if I wanted, I could select this bed and right click down here. I'll show you down here and select a quality, or you can actually go into the mod information and change what like the basic quality is that they built, try to build to. So I've got mine set to they have to build normal before they don't have to deconstruct it. So that's why this one, as soon as she hit normal, she's left it, and this one she keeps rebuilding and she's finally hit normal. It's also a quick way of making sure that their construction goes up quite quick, because with them having to keep deconstructing and reconstruct, it ups their construction, which is always helpful. Let us get a horseshoe pin there. Butcher spot, we will set you to butcher forever. We probably won't butcher there forever, because we're going to hopefully get set up with butcher's table and a kitchen and stuff like that. So I'm going to set it so you do 2 sticks and grilled vegetables and berries. You will pause and on pause at naught. You will pause and on pause at naught, because it just means then that if they get up to 10 and then one of them eats one, they don't go running back to make one. They actually pause in between running around like headless chickens going, oh, we've got one less food. Starting, how much wood have we got? 188. Okay, so I'm going to go back down to 1 speed, and I'm actually going to set priorities now. So we want you both to firefight, patient. Chaffinch is going to be our main doctor, but I do want to set Haze to 4, so then I can say if you get bruises, you're just going to self-tend. Bed rest at a 2. Hull plus at a 2, basics at a 1. You are going to warden and negotiate for anything else. We don't need a handler yet. Chaffinch is going to be a cook. Haze will be the hunter. I will turn your construction off now because you're crap. You will go up on that. I'm going to have both of you be growers and plant cutters, even though you're both kind of mine at 3, because yeah, we don't really need it yet. Whole clean. You will be on management and researcher as and when, which when I get the manager's table, I will lower his grow and plant cut. Did he put a crossbow in? Yes, I did. I went no craft. Might up your craft just so you go and craft stuff as well. They're hungry. I might get priority cut on some berries and mushrooms, just so we get a bit of food. There we go, and we'll do that. They're mostly in the rich soil, so potato, rice because you're quite quick growing, tomato because you're quite quick growing as when you get the skill, squash when you get the skill, heel root definitely when you get the skill, cotton because then we could have clothes. Smoke leaf, which I will probably just sell. This is another one of the mods that I'm using, the pharmacist settings, because they do not need medicine on a bruise. They can still be petted and, oh dear, you got a bruise, oh, poor boo-boo, sort of thing, but you're not gonna have medicine used on the boo-boo. Is Chaffinch cooking? Yes, she is. Cool. So, I might just get them hauled in for her as well. And I will do a dumping stockpile there. And I will say I want that mined off. Them moved in because into the pile because I think I want to build here. I don't know what I want to build. I might do like a row of bedrooms. Okay, let's plan it. So would be a bed there. Gap either side, so that would be the wall. So bed is four. If I did a bedroom that big, we could have a chest of drawers, a light, the bedside table, and then a plant pot. So that is 6 by 6. Wrong size. That size, isn't it? Because then it's bed, plant pot, that, that, and that. Yeah, okay. So we'll just get them built first. I might do like semi-detached houses, so we'll have like a gap. And then I can make a blueprint and copy and like just move it over a couple and do like another two semi-detached houses. Or even do them down here, flip them and do it down here and then do a building here that's like the crafting workshop and then a kitchen. Maybe build the kitchen here because then I can make this into a freezer. Just don't dig in too far because of the bugs. So, yeah, look, 31 degrees outside. But we can tell that this is okay temperature because it is blue. It's not burning red. What are you doing, Hayes? Still chopping? Cool. And she is cooking. That's good. So I'm gonna speed them up a bit. No, we're not gonna have guests until we're more set up and we have like a separate building for guests to go and stay in, and we'll have a stockpile in there with stuff that they can buy if they want it. I've also got the, well, that's like part of the hospitality mod. With that, I can set them to, if there's a good person in the group that's visiting, we can try and recruit them to our cause. Which I always try and do. Because I usually need them. But we're getting there. We are getting there, so as you can see, 23 outside, and we are a lovely, steady 17. So there needs. Should be okay-ish. Not amazing, but okay-ish. Because, yeah, they don't like being in barracks, that's why I've done like two bedrooms. Right, name. I like this one because we are kind of northwest, so we're going to be the northwestern quay faction because we're on the sea. And then the settlement is going to be called the Elegance Town because we are going to try and make it look kind of nice. Probably won't happen, but we can try. So there we go. And you guys all have to let me know if you like having my logo down here or if you want me to put it sort of up here so you can see the buttons down here because it does cut off some of it. But we're doing well. Not a bad start. No deaths yet to deadly mad creatures or anything like that. And they've got an okay mood, even though they are stalkers and no weapons. So not bad. Even my constructor, chaffinch. But you are cooking, yeah. Well, I think food at the moment is more important than construction. We've got it planned, so that's good enough for me for now. I've got defensive positions mod installed, so I can actually set it up and I can, oh look, there we go, mad hair. And I've not set you to fight back yet, have I? Nope. So I'll do that now. Reset you, and there you go, attack it. But yeah, as I was saying, this mod is the defensive positions mod, so once I get defenses set up, I can allocate them each their defensive position, and then whenever I click it, they'll go there instantly instead of me having to go, right, you go there, and you go there, and you go here, and everything like that, which is nice and helpful. How injured are you? Barely bleeding. Oh, you great person. Tend yourself though, just so you don't get infected. There we go. And that can be hauled. And you're starting to plant stuff. Oh, and Chaffinch has gotten built. So, we will put wood flooring. We will get, no, not royal bed. We will get a normal bed. Make sure there's one way, one there, one there. Plant pot, plant pot. Side table, side table. Light, light. Not that we'll get that light anytime soon, because we need power, and then that and that. So, as and when she gets around to it, she can build them, and then they can move in, and then I can uninstall these, and we can put like the research bench there, and we'll research the water wheel first. So we've got power because we've got nice running water here. So yeah, I'm gonna turn that one off for now because we don't really need it. At least she's starting to build stuff up in between cooking. Oh, she's done a good bed, so she can have that first one. So I'll assign that to you. I might actually leave that one up and set that to a medical bed. was chuffing, she's dead anyway, so she's got her own separate one, so they should be happy now. She's got her own bedroom. Oh, she's a night owl. Is she? Oh, she is. Oh, I need to change what hours is it? 11 till 6. Oh, bugger. So you need to sleep there, and you need to work there and do that. So it should be 8 hours of sleep, 2, 4, 6, 8, 2, 4, 6, 8, 2, 4, 6, 8, and work. And you have got an extra, have we got an extra? 2, 4, 5, 2, 4, oh no you haven't. That's right. Okay. Not bothered about sandstone. We've got plenty out around us. So there you go. I'm sorry, Chaffinch. You can go to bed now. You'll be happy. There we go. She should be happier now because she's not awake during the day. Not that she needs that much sleep today, because, like, she slept this night, but never mind. And he's starting to get planting done, that's good. So we'll actually have a supply of food. I need to keep an eye on that area, because if the local critters start eating it, I'm going to have to wall it off and put it as a no-roof area, just so stuff can keep growing, but so critters, except our own teams, can get in. And she's got that one built, but I'm going to leave that until tomorrow for Hayes, because she's going to be in and out building stuff, so I don't want him to get too badly disturbed sleep. He probably already has. Yeah, because she's in and out anyway. But if I get him up now, he's going to stay up, because like his rest isn't too bad. So yeah, I'll leave that until the morning. So she should be really happy because she's a night owl at night. Yeah. Kewl! Kewl, kewl, kewl. So she, what's she doing? Plank cut? Yeah. So we're doing quite well. So I can now set that as his bed because he's up. And I can, this is another mod, miniaturization, I think it's called. Where instead of having to just deconstruct and you lose it, it miniaturizes it and then you can haul it to a stockpile. Which comes in handy when I eventually build the medical ward before, if I've not got hospital beds researched, I can just install like that one and only have to build a few more. So we need to get, what? Oh, it's because my stockpile's empty. Need to find some steel. We've got compacted machine, we've got gold, but I'll leave that there. Uranium. There's some local steel. There we go. Get that miner. Who's on miner? Chaffinch. I might just up that a little bit. Oh, first raid. We haven't got weapons yet. And he has a knife. Are you any good? You can't do social, artistic, mining. You're good at shooting. Hey! I know you. You were out on my list of people to choose from. You got good cooking, good medical. Okay, we can try. We can try. So let us put you there for now, because I haven't got any like sandbags or anything like that built up. Where is he? Here he comes. You're just going to have to beat him with your fists. Let's slow it down a bit. Zoom in and watch. Come on, beat him. Right, Chaffinch, go around that side. Beat on him. Come on. Come on. Gotcha. Okay. So, are you a good... You're a good melee, so equip that knife, please. We'll strip him. Strip him. And I will unset that as medical for now. No, I don't want guests. No. Unset it for prisoners. And we will let him strip him first. And then go capture him. And then do that. And then we're going to haul. And hold that. And we can harvest that mushroom as well, actually. So speed it back up again. Doop 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 doop. So. As a prisoner, we've got 23 resistance, so we're going to reduce that down before we even attempt to recruit. And what are your wounds like? Health. You have been stabbed, so you do need to tend yourself soon. Jeff Inch, you need to prioritize tending yourself, please. And you just tend yourself and then tend him. He had a knife and you had fists. You're not going to bleed now, are you? No, cool. You're going to be a bit tired today, but you'll be fine. And we're getting a supplier. I have got this mod, which is a trading caravan spot where you want them to come and hover. So I'm going to put it on the edge of the water because then I don't have to keep an eye on where they are, so I can just close that message. Which comes in really, really handy. But I've just noticed how long this video is. So I'm actually going to pause it. Who's got the infection? Chaffinch. Oh, Chaffinch. It's because you went to bed without tending yourself. Okay, finish scene to him. And then tend yourself again, please. And then we'll end the video for now. No, Chaffinch. Tend yourself, please. Get rid of the... Start getting immunity. Infection's at 11, immunity is at 10. Okay. Well, I'm going to have to leave it there, and I'll just set Hayes to talk to that gent. Is it a gent? I think it's a gent. Yes, it is. Okay. We'll set Hayes to talk to that gent. Anyway, I'm going to leave the video here, and we will see you next time.